Hey everybody, Dr. Brian Wickstrom here with River City Chiropractic, and today we're continuing talking about whiplash, and in this video we're going to be discussing some of the common myths that surround whiplash type injuries. And so the first one is, I feel fine. Okay, and so this, you know, sometimes a pain or issues take some time, the symptoms don't always show up right away, and pain isn't always a good indicator of, you know, where you're at with your health. And so I always tell people that, you know, only about 5 to 10% of the nerves in your body actually sense pain. So just like you can have an artery blocked, you know, 60, 70, 80, 90% and have no pain or, you know, symptoms and have a major heart attack, you can have nerve damage, you know, a significant amount, if it isn't affecting that small percentage of nerves that actually detects the pain. Well, you may not know that there's a problem there, especially in the beginning, until the damage, you know, kind of builds and just progressively gets worse. And so that's why it's important to make sure that you see somebody that can do a thorough exam and find out what's going on, you know, as soon as possible following a whiplash injury. And so just to put things in perspective, during, you know, just an 8 mile an hour impact in your car, which isn't very much, most people would consider that a you know, minor, you know, fender bender, but within that, you know, second or two, the head can move about 18 inches, and that can have upwards of 7 g's of force on your spine in just a matter of seconds. And so the challenge, or the Discovery space shuttle was only designed to withstand about 3 g's of force. And so you can have way more, double that in just an 8 mile an hour impact in your car, and that can definitely cause a lot of issues and set things in motion to lead to more chronic debilitating problems down the road. And so seeing somebody who specializes in whiplash, you know, particularly like a chiropractor or corrective chiropractor, can really be beneficial for you, because it's going to address more of the underlying cause of problem and the surrounding structures with your spine to get things back moving in the right direction again. So number two is, I was told I'm fine, so I must be fine. Okay. So following a whiplash injury, maybe a sports, maybe, you know, auto accident, a lot of times people visit urgent care, maybe even go into the hospital just to get checked out, you know, kind of see where things are at. And so that's definitely a good thing to do right away, because those facilities, thank God, they're there to save your life in a crisis. And so if you have any internal bleeding, broken bones, things like that, they're going to be able to hopefully catch those things, and you'll be able to fix that. And so that way your body can start to heal. However, their definition of fine is, again, you know, it's just looking at those life-threatening illnesses or you know, injuries. Okay, they're not really looking at the surrounding structures of the spine, if there's any ligament damage there, what your range of motion looks like. So most of the time, you know, if there isn't any life-threatening, you know, problems, then people are sent home with a concoction of anti-inflammatories, muscle relaxers, maybe some painkillers. And so people, you know, start taking those, and, you know, they're feeling fine. Their inflammation maybe goes down a little bit, but the root issue, the real serious problem, is still there, because they didn't really do anything to actually address it. And so that's where seeing a corrective chiropractor comes in place, because once we've determined that you don't have any life, you know, threatening issues, then now we got to start to work on the spine. Whiplash causes people to lose the curves in the neck, may cause ligament damage there. And so, you know, having a proper evaluation done can be very beneficial for you. And literally just in a couple days time, you'll start to see noticeable changes with the joints in your spine. After just 2 weeks, people start to develop a permanent damage to the spine and the discs. And so sometimes people go years before ever really, you know, doing anything about it, and it makes it a lot more difficult to fix the longer that time goes on. Plus, there's less likelihood that your auto insurance, if it was from an auto accident, is going to cover anything, you know, because it was years ago, and a lot can happen in the meantime. So once you determine that you don't have any life-threatening things going on, then, you know, I would definitely make sure that you see a corrective chiropractor. Third thing is, it was just a minor fender bender, or, you know, there wasn't a lot of damage to the actual vehicle, so I must be fine. It's not a big deal. So the issue is that they're constructing cars these days to be a lot safer, which is definitely a good thing. The body and the chassis are a lot more rigid. The bumpers are better, so they're built to withstand, you know, and handle the forces more effectively. The problem is that the forces are still there, even just a minor fender bender. In fact, now the forces get transmitted into more the occupants in the vehicle than they actually do into the car. And so, as I discussed before, so even just an 8 mile an hour impact can have upwards of 7 g's of force on the spine, and that's transmitted into the actual person in there. So I look at this like, you know, like analogy is, you know, checking eggs at the grocery store. So if you're going to the grocery store to buy a carton of eggs, chances are you're going to be opening up the carton to look in there to see what the eggs look like. Okay. On the outside, the carton of the eggs might look fine and dandy and everything looks good. But on the inside, if that carton's been dropped or damaged or bumped somehow, there may be some broken eggs in there. That's kind of what can happen with your car. The car may look fine, but those forces are just transmitted to the things on the inside, which in, you know, in this situation might be the people in the car. And so it's always a good idea to get your, you know, get evaluated done by a corrective chiropractor. And so that way you can determine if there's any underlying problems that need to be addressed and make sure that it's not going to be really in fact impacting you down the road. So those are the three common myths that surround whiplash. And I hope you found this video helpful for you. And we will talk to you in the next video.